Hi, I'm Sam, and I'm a software engineer at Meta. I'm going to be talking with you all about the Functorch project, which adds composable function transforms to Pytorch. During this talk, we'll go through the following parts. For anyone unfamiliar with the project, we'll walk through the basic idea of Functorch. Then, we'll move into some standard examples that Functorch improves. We'll also discuss some more recent research examples that Functorch improves. Finally, we'll talk about what's next for Functorch. Let's start with what is Functorch. Functorch has added JAX-like composable function transforms to Pytorch. JAX is a library from Google that originally introduced these new transforms. For new users, this might still be intimidating, so we'll break down what that means. Function transforms mean that it's a higher order function that accepts a numerical function and returns a new function. The new function transforms or changes the behavior, so the return function returns a different quantity. Composable means that they can nest arbitrarily. Examples include grad of f, which will compute the second derivative, and vmap of grad of f, which will produce per sample gradients. Some things like per sample gradients and higher order forward mode can't be computed efficiently in stock PyTorch. As a note, our examples will not use functionalize, but Brian Hirsch is presenting this here. Functorch offers a version of this that works with other transforms like vmap and grad. Now, we'll look at some basic examples of Functorch. In typical examples, we'll want to compute the gradients with respect to all other examples together. In the example of per sample gradients, we would instead like to get the gradients with respect to each individual sample and stack them together. There's no way to compute this efficiently in stock PyTorch. Similarly, there's no way to do model ensembling in stock PyTorch. In model ensembling, a user has multiple replicas of the same model with different hyperparameters or initializations. They'll use the output of all of these models to come up with a final prediction. Finally, we can compose the vmap and grad-like transforms to get efficient Jacobian and Hessian computation. Functorch offers APIs for Jacobians computed with forward and reverse mode AD. Additionally, the default Hessian offered does forward over reverse computation, but users can choose to use reverse over reverse or forward over forward if that suits their use case the best. Now, we'll look at some examples of Functorch from research. In meta-agnostic meta-learning, commonly called MAML, a user trains their model on a batch of tasks given here by X1 and Y1. For each of these tasks, the model is trained on a new learning task given by X2 and Y2. Functorch allows for efficient batching of tasks in the inner loop. Another final example that benefits from Functorch is neural tangent kernels. These are used to describe how a neural net trains and have become popular in studying networks that are hard to describe traditionally, such as networks with large layer widths. This example describes an empirical neural tangent kernel using a Jacobian contraction. For two data points, this is defined as the matrix product between the two Jacobians of the model at the points. The batched case is shown here with two batches, X1 and X2. Here, we now compute the matrix product between the Jacobians of all combinations of points in X1 and X2. To fit on the slide, I've excluded the einsum that does the matrix product between the Jacobians. Now, we'll look at the future of Functorch. We're very excited that Functorch has been released in tree in 1.13. This means that you can download PyTorch through standard channels and import Functorch without needing an extra download. As we move forward, we're focused on a couple of core areas. We're planning to rationalize Functorch with the rest of PyTorch, which will mean that Functorch will be integrated into PyTorch's library. Additionally, we've had a lot of requests for support of custom autograd functions. This is something we're actively working on and are excited to hear feedback or use cases on. We're also looking at supporting data-dependent control flow and integration with the PT2 stack. Finally, we've begun looking at how we could use developments from the distributed team to build a parallelism transform, akin to JAX's PMAP. The Functorch team from Meta includes Richard Zhao, Horace He, Animesh Jain, and myself. We would like to thank the Google JAX team for their novel framework, which was the original inspiration for this project. Additionally, we would like to thank GitHub users and QuantSight developers VFDev5 and Kishitage12345 for their outsized contributions. Finally, we would like to thank the PyTorch core and compiler teams at Meta for their countless projects that have enabled Functorch.